Do you get dizzy and your heart starts racing when standing up? You may have dysautonomia, a disorder developed by more than half of long haulers. Dysautonomia is a disorder that affects our autonomic nervous system. This is the system that helps us regulate involuntary physiological processes like heart rate, blood pressure, digestion, and breathing. And one of the most common forms of dysautonomia is postural orthostatic tachycardia syndrome, or POTS, a condition that affects blood flow. The key characteristic of POTS is an abnormal increase in heart rate when standing up. Normally, when we stand up, gravity pulls blood down. The brain signals blood vessels in the legs to tighten and push blood upwards. People with POTS cannot tighten the blood vessels. So the brain then decides to increase the speed and pressure of our heartbeats to compensate and pull up blood to the upper body parts. The increase in heart rate is usually enough for us not to faint, but it doesn't provide the normal levels of blood our organs and brain need. This leads to more problems. Some people may feel shortness of breath, fatigue, tightness of chest, dizziness, stomach problems, and many other symptoms. So, why do long haulers suffer from POTS? There are three proposed mechanisms. COVID can put us in bed for quite some time. This inactivity deconditions the heart, which basically means the heart is out of shape. This is definitely not what we want when we need a heart working correctly. And then, COVID-19 also impairs the RAS system, a complex system in our body that helps us regulate blood pressure, blood volume, balancing of fluids, and other cardiovascular functions. An impaired RAS system can lead to lower levels of blood and a decrease in electrolytes, like sodium. This loss of fluids is a condition known as hypovolemia. The combination of a heart out of shape and lower blood levels causes our heart to pump low volumes of blood. To compensate, the brain signals our heart to pump faster. A more direct way of developing POTS may be due to COVID-19 damaging the brain and spinal cord. There are several ways COVID can damage the brain, from the virus infiltrating into the brain and damaging nerves to having a compromised respiratory system that is not providing enough oxygen, which also damages the nerves. People with COVID-19 sometimes generate antibodies that attack their own body tissue. Evidence shows that some of these antibodies may attack a collection of neural bodies from the autonomic nervous system, which can also lead to dysautonomia. If people develop dysautonomia caused by antibodies, then immunotherapy may be helpful, for which there is some evidence supporting this treatment. So how is POTS often treated? There are several treatments for alleviating POTS symptoms. One of the first suggestions is probably to take lots of water and salt to recover fluids and increase blood levels. Probably as important is doing exercise to recondition the heart. But before doing any exercise, make sure to discuss it with your doctor. A study reported that the symptoms of people with long COVID might worsen when exercising. There is also having a diet high in fiber and complex carbohydrates, having frequent meals, and sleeping 7 to 10 hours at night with the head of the bed raised 6 to 10 inches. Pharmacological treatments could range from meds used to constrict blood vessels, reduce tachycardia, and treat other specific symptoms. There are many potential treatments. I'll leave a link with more recommendations in the description below. Each case of POTS is different, and symptoms may come and go. Still, you can visit the doctor and follow the recommendations to improve your quality of life. So stay safe and see you in the next video.